Hi guys, my name is Michelle and I create hair, makeup and lifestyle content here on YouTube. So recently I bought a few Bella Waste lip crayons from Purple. So I don't know if you guys know, but in most of my YouTube videos I'm wearing the shade Lean On by Bella Waste. This is their matte lip crayon. And I already had two shades from the brand. As you can see, Lean On is a shade that I love a lot and that I've used a lot in these last 7 months. And since I really like the formula of the Bella Waste lip crayons, I thought let me just pick up a few more and show you guys what these look like. So my skin tone, I am an NC42 and I have a yellow undertone, like a very strong yellow undertone. My forehead is much darker than the rest of my face. These are really, really reasonable, really, really nice. I love the formulas and they wear very well on the lips. And since picking your shade online is going to be so difficult, I want to make it a little easier for you guys. And so I thought, let me feature these on my channel. So I have four shades here and the very first shade that we're going to be talking about is called That's What I Like, and this is shade number 01. So this is like a warm, muted, muddy, browny, orangey pink, but it's more like on the browny, orangey side. This is what it looks like. This is like a very nice, pretty, nudey color, but if you want something that is a little more than a nude, a little more color than a nude, and you want it like on the browny, orangey side, then I feel like you'll really like this color. So, the reason I enjoy wearing lip crayons is because, okay, it is not super matte. No matter what they tell you, if you're not wearing a liquid lipstick, then it is not going to be that super matte finish. It is always going to be like a demi matte finish, but there are some advantages to that. Although these lip crayons have a teeny tiny bit of a sheen, so this is like a demi matte finish, in a few hours the sheen goes away and then you're left with a matte lip. And plus, lip crayons are very easy to control if you have thin lips like mine and you feel like you're not very adventurous with lipsticks, then a lip crayon might really be good for you. Because look, let's talk about liquid lipsticks. Unless you have lip injections, you have lines on your lips. We all have lines on our lips. And a liquid lipstick is just gonna enhance those lines and make you feel all crusty and cracked lippy. And so when I'm not looking for long-lasting lipsticks, then I always go for a lip crayon because it is just so much easier to use. It is so much easier to handle. This is like in between like a lip pencil and a lipstick. So you have that control if you want to overdraw or you want to overline your lips. You definitely have that control with a lip crayon. They're very, very, very easy to handle. So this is what the lipstick looks like on a DSLR, right? Under artificial light. I want to show you what the lipsticks look like in sunlight and also when you don't have foundation on. Because listen, when I don't have any time to do my makeup and I want to go out, I want to just step out the door and I want to look like half decent, like somewhat presentable, then these lip crayons are so insane because you just smack it on and you're done and you feel like you don't look pika anymore. You feel like there's like some color on your lips, you feel like somewhat presentable. And like in 1 hour, the sheen will go. So you'll be left with like the pigmentation on your lips, but it's gonna fade really nicely. Especially this color. This color is going to fade really nicely. None of my pigmentation peeks through at all. This is like a color that you'll enjoy if you like orangey muddy colors, but you don't want it to be like in your face orange and you don't want it to be in your face brown and you want like that in between color. Really, really pretty. That being said, let's look at what the shade looks like in sunlight and without any foundation on. Okay, this shade is called That's What I Like and it is such a pretty color. As you can see, it has like a slight sheen to it. But it's really, really pretty. This is indoor footage. This is also indoor footage. And let me show you what it looks like in sunlight. I mean, how stunning is this color? This is what it looks like in sunlight. Really, really pretty. The next color is 07 and it's called One Dance. Okay, so this is number 7, One Dance. And as you can see, this color is pretty close to my lip shade. So it's like this warm pinky shade. You can see some of my pigmentation peeking through just slightly, just a tan bit. So I feel like this lip crayon definitely has a little more sheen than the last one that we tried. That being said, let's look at what this lipstick looks like on a phone camera without foundation and in sunlight. Okay, so this is the shade One Dance, 07 One Dance. And this is what it looks like in sunlight. It's a really pretty color. This is the next shade, shade number 11, Lean On. This is what I have on my lips in most of my YouTube content. And now I'm sure this looks pretty familiar. Oh, by the way, these lip crayons are totally sharpenable, which is why it looks so small in comparison to the other lip shades that I have. I really, really, really like this color. This is like a total MLBB shade for me. So it gives me just a hint of color. I also feel like since it's like a demi matte finish, it gives me a tiny bit of sheen, but not so much. It definitely wears out. This shade hides all of my pigmentation, and very honestly, if you ask me, this is the best shade of lipstick that I've ever owned. So this is definitely like a nude lipstick. It has a tiny hint. It's like on the warm side, but it also has a tiny bit of blue. So pinks, right? When we're talking about nudes, they could be like a bluey pink or it could be like a muddy pink, right? This, I feel like, definitely has a little bit of brown in there, but it also has a tiny bit of like blue in there as well, especially when I swatch it on my hand. But when I swatch it on my lips, then it looks like a warm nude, my lips but better shade. That being said, let's look at what this color looks like in natural light without foundation and on a phone camera. And this is what it looks like indoors. And as you can see, look, different cameras, different phones have different colors, and which is why you'll always see that there's a slight deviation. But yeah, this is like a pinky MLBB shade. It's really pretty. Let me show you what this is gonna look like in sunlight. This is what the color looks like in sunlight. Last but not least, number 15, this is called The Lady in Red. I use this color in my Lalpar Shari in my Ashtami look. I'll link that video up here. So listen, this is like a cool toned red, so it has a bit of blue in there. So whenever you wear a cool toned red, it is always going to enhance the green around your mouth. And so the best way to wear a shade like this is to color correct with a little orange around the face. When I'm on stage and stuff, I generally always color correct. So if you want a video on that, let me know and I'll make one. Alright, let's look at what this shade looks like when I don't have any foundation on, under natural sunlight and on a phone camera. Okay, this is the lady in red. I don't have any pigmentation peeping through either. This is what it looks like in sunlight. It's definitely a very stunning color. And yeah, I like it. It's pretty. Alright guys, so that was it. These were all 4 shades that I own from Bella Waste. They're having an insane discount, so 1:1. And I haven't seen too many people talking about Bella Waste lipsticks, so I thought let me make this video. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video. If you did, give me a thumbs up, leave me a comment. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.